and
with no problem.
About teachers who can stay residentially and demonstrate and do the whole thing and make people do, we are very glad to inform you that we have trained quite a handful of people who are ready to go anywhere and stay for some months or 1 year to train the people and show the way practically and come back. I am ready to supply one or two to you if the work is made to start in your community. Exactly, exactly. They know the legume plantations and fruit gardens and doing the seasonal work for the gardening. They are trained on practical lines. Or if anyone comes and stays with us for some time, they can also know and go and do the same thing there. Pardon? It is. My address is east coast of South India. No, it is called Visakhapatnam, east coast, between Madras and Calcutta. No, until about 3 years, we need not give anything separately in the name of education to the child. Only two factors work as education to the child of the tender age. One is not to treat the child harshly in any way. That is to obstruct or chide the child in a harsh way. And the second aspect is the parents should have something in their behavior which the child can see and imitate, and they should be careful in not presenting scenes to the children that are detrimental. For example, the fighting of husband and wife, the scene presented to the child, or the irritable outbursts of one of them towards anyone. And this is enough for a child before a child is three. And without these things, no amount of education is of use if we dump upon the child. It is only from the vibrations we give to the child and the positive presence that the parents give to the child that the child develops. So our vibrations and our aura should help the child. It is through magnetization and not to indoctrination that a child develops. It is a creative process and not an instructive process in the tender age. It can be started quite young from the stage of narratives. But let the idea of religion be eliminated and the idea of the science of spiritualism be inculcated. Because let the child have universal values instead of having the terms of our own people and other people. The concept of religion automatically gives the idea of our own people and other people. You can inculcate the whole of the Holy Bible without a concept of religion. You can give the light of the Christ without a concept of religion. You can teach Bhagavad Gita without indoctrinating the child. So, let the idea of religion not be introduced to the child at all in the modern age. Let all the so-called religious education be introduced in a universal scientific way. Let all the so-called religious education be introduced to the child in a universal and scientific way. That is what we are doing in India. our children know as much of Christ as they know of Bhagavad Gita, as much of Buddha, etc. And in their view, there are no sinners and believers. Like that, we can train from quite from the childhood. Whenever it is possible, it may be in the next season, or if a personal conversation is possible at any time, I can give you some ideas. Yes, exactly. But the education we impart to the child with all these details I have described is in no way detrimental to the recollection of the child of its own life mission. Our education is instructive only to that extent where it gives a stimulation to the past recollections of the child and enables the child to develop into its own legitimate dimensions. There is no harm in giving instructions at a certain age. It is only to expose the various subjects to the mind of the child and wait and allow the child to choose for itself and then begin to instruct the child. Am I clear? That's true, but one more point is to be taken into consideration. The aspect of ages is not very strict in this method. It is only arbitrary. Just as nature gives us physical bodies irrespective of the differences in our past karma, it gives a mold which is an average to every human being, rather a common mold which we call the human frame. At the same time, this physical frame is in no way detrimental to the recollection of one's own mission in life. Just as nature gives a physical frame to the human being, we can offer an educational frame to every child, which is an average, by getting exposed to which the child may get the stimulation to develop into his own line. My experience says that it is quite possible by not fixing the rules rigidly. If one is really devoted to his mission, 1 year is more than enough. Please repeat, I am not able to follow. Please. No, unless one applies his physical activity to some physical plane work, it is not at all possible to regulate the thinking of anyone. That's why some inevitable work on the physical plane should be prescribed to the child. And it should be directed in such a way that it regulates the thinking of the child. That is what I mentioned. Meditation for some time during the same hour and minute every day is necessary, and it should be in such a way that the child is in meditation during his other times of activity also. And meditation should be of an applied nature to his routine, and his progress into the spiritual goal should not be unilateral. It should include his other activities also, so that the whole activity gives him a direction into proper meditation, so that a mean can be touched between karma yoga and jnana yoga. That is the science of work and the science of thinking. Sport. It should be there, it is inevitable. All the methods that are existing now should never be discarded. We have to give only a proper field of action. That is, the setup of a family should be given, that's all. The child should be educated in a community, that is all the difference. Games should be there for a child. The child who is trained in such an institution which I have described till now, it develops multidimensionally and all positively, and it never goes into the situations when it requires a protection from the aggressive nature of the present world. Because our experience of such children trained in under such conditions is, they are able to influence their environment in a positive manner, and they are the least affected by the negativeness and the aggressiveness of the world. And whoever comes into contact with the products of such institutes, they will understand the usefulness of human values, and automatically they are getting changed instead of doing something harmful to these people. This is our experience with the children that are trained under these lines. They know how to manage with such situations better than those who are suffering in the world. Because when once you begin to experience the tranquil way of living, your environment will be affected by you in the positive way. Whereas you are the least affected by your environment wherever you exist.
Here, two vast subjects. Each of it requires a separate conference. It is enough if we remember that karma is the chain action of the universe activity that is making the solar systems and the planets work. And when we come to the three lower principles of man, that is matter, force and mind, karma works as cause and effect theory. That is, in this plane, when we do something or speak something or think something, it sets into movement a series of chain actions which we are bound to follow until the legitimate end. So, this is the meaning of the word karma on the lower planes. Whereas on the higher planes, karma means the law according to which the creation occurs. More than this, we have to explain in a lecture. Even that we can explain only in short for the present. If you observe a magnet, there are the physical dimensions of the magnet which are different from the magnetic lines they produce. And you can see the magnet only and not the magnetic lines. At the same time, you cannot deny the existence of the magnetic lines. Because when you conduct an experiment with iron dust, you will find the truth of it. And just as magnetism is different from the physical magnet, your existence is different from your physical body. And you exist much beyond the physical dimensions of your body, just as magnetism exists beyond the physical dimensions of the piece of magnet. So, the part you exist around your physical body is called by many names, and aura is
one name. It is your own presence beyond your physical body. For the present, this much can be explained. So, thank you all.